Hello and welcome back. I'm James Rose and this is EU4, Mandate of Heaven. So, this is the first episode of our trial of Korea for Mandate of Heaven. This is a short series I'm doing up until Mandate of Heaven's release, where I try out Japan, Korea, the Manchu, and the Ming. This is the review copy of Mandate of Heaven, and as I said at the start of the Japan video, I got this review copy from Gamers Entertainment Network. So it'd be really great if you guys could go and check out their website. There's a link in the description. You'd be indirectly supporting me and directly supporting them by checking it out. So it won't take up much of your time just clicking on a website and having a look, will it? So go and do it. Okay, so without any more, I explained what we're doing more so in the Japan run. So go check out that video for a more thorough explanation. Let's start. We're rivaled with Jin Zhao. How much money are we making? 1.8, so we're not going to hire any advisors. Our monarch points, we're getting quite a lot. We've got a good... King Do Yi is a good ruler. With 655. Unfortunately, he's 48, so we're not going to be able to keep him for very long. We're a despotic monarchy. We've just rivaled Jin Zhao. We are a tributary of the Ming. So we have Ming to defend us in defensive wars, which is good. Can we still form alliances? Yes, we can. Excellent. So what we probably want to do is form an alliance with, well, any of these guys just to help, because we're going to attack Jin Zhao to start with. Ming love us. We should probably improve relations with the Ming as well. So what have we got actually? What are our missions? Protect our brethren of Hetu Allah. So we've got this province here. 13 dev. That would give us monthly autonomy change. That's only in that one province. We can improve relations with the Ming for better dip rep and improve our prestige for admin points. I can't see our prestige going up by 50 very quickly. I'm going to do improve relations with the Ming. That's an easy mission to do. So we're going to straight away start doing that. We can also royal marry them. I think we're also going to improve relations. We'll start with... I don't know how you say it. Suggestions in the comments. We'll improve relations with them. They can be our ally and we'll conquer around them to start with. For now, we can turn off our army maintenance. That's not necessary. Trade, I think, is fine. I had a quick look before I started recording. Alright, what are our ideas? We have cheaper construction cost, we have plus 25% domestic trade power, and our ambition is to have plus 10% infantry combat ability. That's not a bad one. We get minus 5% tech cost, that's nice. Grand code for state administration, minus 10% stab, yeah, plus 10% production, plus 5% ship durability, plus 10% national manpower modifier, minus 10% idea cost, and plus 10% national tax modifier. So those are our ideas. We can straight away take Found the Hall of Worthies. It's going to cost us 50 ducats, which we have, and 30 admin, which we also have, and that will give us half a prestige each year for the rest of the game. Don't mind if I do. That's what it is. We are Confucian, which is one of the two upgraded religions in this patch, the other being Shinto. So as a Confucianist nation, how are we actually looking for Confucian here? There's quite a bit of Jin Zhao provinces that are also Confucian, so that's nice. As a Confucian nation, we have the Harmony Bar, and as well as converting nations, we can also harmonize them, which makes them so that they're treated as a true faith religion. If you want more explanation on that, go check out my live stream video that's already up. Or alternatively, I'm going to do a couple of videos when the patch goes live officially, detailing changes and new features and things like that. So for now, we have my Mahayana already harmonized, and that's giving us cheaper idea costs. That's nice. Let's see, we can turn our forts off, they're unnecessary. We have Ming as our overlord, and let's see what we can do about getting ourselves some extra monarch points straight off. Do we have centers of trade? We do. They should be owned by the merchant guilds. We only have that one. Can we then... Okay, we can't use that to get... I'm tempted to give them something else. Is there perhaps another good province to give them? None of these provinces appear to actually be any good as far as trade goes. Where's something that makes... Is there... Okay, we got three. Looking for any trade goods that are particularly valuable. Three seems to be the best one. Okay, so they can have this Chinaware province. Okay, no, they can't. Needs to have at least 10 development. Okay, they can have this Chinaware province. There we go. Now they have enough influence that we can get a bit more monarch points off them, and we can get a bit of money off them. Okay, so that's all I think we need to go through with that. What's our force limit like? We can get four more. We already have four cavs, so that's good. So we want four more infantry. Naval force limit, I think we want three more light ships. There we go. And that should be it for now. We have one diplomat not doing anything. I'm thinking maybe improving relations with the Ashikaga Shogunate. Because until they actually form... until Japan's been going a little while, we probably just want to be friendly with them. Well, perhaps we could improve relations with Yeren or someone. We'll go with Yeren, just so we are improving relations with somebody who has some level of importance. We'll put it on speed 3 and go. You guys are going to protect trade in Nippon. Jin Zhao has insulted us. I'm not particularly surprised. King Doe is now benevolent. Minus 5 liberty desiring subjects. Excellent. In fact, I'm going to pull back from Yeren. And instead, we're going to build a spy network on Jin Zhao. Ming demands 4 ducats. Okay. You can have it, Ming. Don't worry. We are your slave. And we will be the best slave we can be. Now, what is interesting, if I'll probably talk about this in more detail in the Jin Zhao run, but the mechanic that the Paradox devs have put in to facilitate the collapse of Ming is having them border a large tribe. And as Korea, what we're likely to do is in fact eat the tribes. Especially, you have to also keep in mind at this point that Ming is much more powerful this patch. What we're likely to do in Korea is eat the tribes. And by doing that, we're actually stopping the disaster that causes the collapse of Ming. So I think that's somewhat interesting. Because it would mean that... Okay, they're going to demand military power instead now. We're going to be a tributary for Ming for quite a while in that case. Because they have 1,000 development. And if we are weaker than them and we cancel being a tributary, chances are they're going to attack us. Jin Zhao's attacked Yeren. Have they managed to make any allies themselves? No, they've become a tributary of Ming and that's it. They're now also in a war, so they can't make any alliances. So that's all good for us, as far as I'm concerned. What might we want to do next? Let's have a look at the ages. We can when we attack Janzhao, we can humiliate them. That will give us one of the things here. We can also, we're likely to also get a large city and embrace Renaissance. I would think. Because we're going to want to do both of those things. The large city will come from us working towards the Renaissance. I'm thinking our capital is the best place for us. Yeah, looks like it. So we'll develop the Renaissance in our capital. What does this do? Land force limit. Is anyone we're particularly interested in for an advisor? We have a bit of money going spare. We may want a morale of armies guy, actually, for when we attack the Janzhao. We actually can attack them soon. I'm going to bring these guys together. I'm going to go and... Where's the most ports here? I think they have one thing in each. But we'll go up and put our fleet next to them. Where is our light fleet? I'm going to bring that into here as well. We will start paying our troops and stick them on the border up here. Is there somewhere where we can actually stick them all? We'll probably want to go for their capital straight off, so we'll put them here. Ming, we can marry you, can't we? No diplomats to send. Hixi, will you ally me? Not yet. Okay. So what I want to do is, before we make our claim on Janzhao, I want to try and finish our mission with the Ming. There we go. And that should then give us a mission on Janzhao. Yep. So we have two choices. Okay. Conquering Hunkan, attrition for enemies, I don't think is particularly great. So we'll go for Hetu Ala. What have we got here? We'll put a claim on this province, and then we'll use the mission for Hetu Ala to get a second claim. There we go. We'll leave our diplomat there making a spy network. You guys go back to protecting trade. If you take any damage, go home. You're not going to go home at war, though. I'm actually going to send these guys over here so that we can see if... Okay, they don't have any ships currently in dock. Ming wants some military points, okay. Hey, it said that this was fine. It's winter now, isn't it? Split the army and send half of it down here. I don't know where their fleet is likely to be. Hello, noble families, feud. Rebels, autonomy, or diplo. We'll just give some autonomy. Okay, one more month and we will declare the war. I'm looking out to see if I can spot where Janzhao's navy is. Oh, there it is. It's up there. They have 5 galleys. We have 9. So I reckon we can probably take them. We will stick our forts on. It is the beginning of the month. We need a general. I'm tempted to try our leader because he's not young, but I also don't really want to tempt him to die. Actually, I think our heir can be a general. You're now a general. You're actually not bad. So we will have you lead the charge. And we will declare on Janzhao. We're going to declare for their capital, I think. Then... I did that wrong. We're going to send them into there. We've got 6,000 men back here supporting. We want 7,000 men to move into here. We'll take 1,000 cavalry and send them around to occupy that province and bring the other 1,000 up here. Hooah. And we're also going to slap that guy in. to increase our chances of winning in battles. They have 14,000 men. We have to keep in mind their men are actually a lot stronger than ours one-on-one. So we don't want to be engaging in any fair fights. We've already partly accomplished that by declaring on them while they're already in a war. You go, in fact, I don't really want to try blockading. Which sea is this? This is the East China Sea. You hunt around in the East China Sea. You take any damage, go and repair. So what we want out of this war is to humiliate Jian Zhao and take at least the two provinces we have claims on, maybe a bit more. Ming loves us because we're great. We are losing a bit of money right now, but it's not the end of the world. Okay, we caught the fleet. They lost two galleys. We lost one, so that is in our favour. Ming is influencing random nations because Ming has way too much money and they have no idea what to do with it all. Because they're super OP this patch. I do have to wonder if they will nerf Ming at all. I don't think they will. What I wouldn't mind them doing is maybe buffing the Manchu tribes. Because from what I've seen so far in a few little test runs, is that Korea eats the Manchu tribes. But we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Because I haven't obviously played any full games yet. So I don't know what happens past. I think the latest I've played to is only like 1480. I can't really make any informed comments yet. No, Ming's influencing everyone. They want to be everyone's best buddy. Hey, Jian Zhao has fallen. Good, in fact, you can stay there. We have two armies ready to attack if necessary. In fact, I'm going to pull these guys back to here because then they can support each other through here as well as both supporting the siege of Jianzhou's capital. Okay, so what we want is we want a humiliate because it's an objective for this time frame, and then we want at least that. Oop, looks like we caught their fleet and this time it went incredibly poorly for them. Excellent. So once these guys have healed up, I'm going to have them blockade the enemy ports. Chuck some admin points at Ming. We have another merchant free. Not merchant, diplomat. We have a merchant free, that's probably why I'm saying that. Maybe we can make friendly with Ryukyu. Maybe we can make Ryukyu our servant and have them conquer the world in our name. We send our diplomat back to Ming. Having good relations with the giant of Ming is never going to be a bad thing. I set you guys to blockade, didn't I? Yeah. So when they're all repaired, they'll go and blockade. Now that we've destroyed the Manchu Navy. We did lose a ship, though. Oh, no, yeah, but then we captured a ship, so it's all evened out. I was expecting this to fall faster than that, but... this is a new feature in this patch for those of you, I believe, with Mandate of Heaven. I'll do a video going through things like that when the actual patch comes out. But if you have enough artillery, you can now force a breach walls on the enemy for 50 military points. Which means that, theoretically, if you're rolling in military points, which you usually are in this game, you can have... wars go much faster, or sieges at least go much faster. Come on, capture it. God damn it. Unfortunately, cannons haven't been invented yet, so we can't do that. Go on. You know you want to. All the defenders are deserting. I don't know how they're getting out. We're supposed to be sieging this place, so as far as I'm concerned, we should have it surrounded. So I don't know how the deserters are getting out, but... We have good spy network on Jan's out. We could probably... I wish we could submit 8 claims while we're at war with them. That'd be nice. Have a look at areas. Okay, so if we were to take these, we'd be taking all different areas. Now, I'm not too concerned at taking a giant amount of territory right now. I think I'm just going to take these two territories because they're what we have claims on. I don't want to spend diplo points unnecessarily, because we're going to need all of our monarch points to spawn the Renaissance when it appears. Hey, there we go. That gives us 90% war score. We do need a diplomat though. Let's pull back from Ming for a second. We'll see what we can get war score wise now, and if they still won't give us what we want, we'll go and occupy the rest of their territory. Okay, so we can get our humiliate, we can get these two provinces, then I want all of their money and some war reps. That doesn't allow us enough left to do anything else that we want, I don't think. So we'll take that. There we go. We completed our mission and expanded Korea's territory a little bit. We've also now fulfilled one of the objectives for this age, so we can start accumulating a bit more splendor. What's our devastation like? Here's an, because this is a new feature in this patch. Devastation. So we have 5.6% there, 11.4% there because we looted it dry, and 7.16% there. Okay. That's not too bad. That should tick down fairly quickly. We have a fort here, so that'll cause this to tick down very quickly. Yeah, friendly fort. But this one's going to tick down much slower because there's not a fort in the vicinity. Rival of our rival, make Haxi like us. I mean, we were currently trying to do that. I was planning on allying them. Okay, they do want an alliance, so that'll help with our mission. In fact, we should probably just stick our men into these territories to stop. Here we go. That's an alliance there. Can we marry them? We need to wait until some time. Oh, they've sent us a marriage request. There we go. That's that mission done. Some more monarch points for us. Protect our brethren in Jin Zhao. We'll take that mission, and so when our truce runs out, we can attack there. We also have enough spy points to get another claim. Let's go for this one. It's on the coast. And we're going to slowly, systematically eat our way through Jin Zhao, and we'll see where we are after that. Let's also disattach our heir from the army, although we might want to leave him there. I think him having him attached increases the likelihood of him dying, and he sucks. So him dying is not a problem. We're going to kick this guy. We are now behind on admin points, so I'm going to hire... Thanks, Ming. We'll take this guy for more prestige. Nothing wrong with that. We could disinherit this heir, but that would be a big prestige hit I don't really want to take right now. We're at peace, so monthly autonomy is not going to do much. We'll keep getting our... Oh no, our agent's been discovered. Spy network discovered. Minus 1,000%. Okay. Let's just pull him back then. We'll send another guy back down to Ming to make friendly with the big guy. Ah, get him, boss. That's what we're going to be saying later when we're abusing our relationship with Ming. Kind of want to make friendly with Japan as well. Let's make friendly with Japan. Korea and Japan didn't have historically good relations, but we can change that. We will be the best of friends this time around. We can also turn our forts off. That'll save us a bit of money. Forts, 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 military tab. Okay. We're making a bit of money now. That's not too bad. And we're not going to be declaring ourselves bankrupt anytime soon. Almost got what we need for our hex. Not going to boost stability, especially while we have overextension. That'd be silly. We're slowly gaining harmony, but we haven't got any non-Confucianist provinces, so we can't do anything with harmony. Although, I think from what I've looked at so far, Ming is forcing Chagatai to be a tributary. Here, we'll recall from there. Ming, how are you doing with tributaries? You've got a lot of them. So, you're going to force Chagatai, and then I guess you'll move on to the Oira? Because it seems to me Ming just wants all of the bordering countries to be its tributaries. We'll take all these techs, because we are bordering with rival nations. And we don't want to look weak. I say once the Renaissance has spawned, we're going to want to spend all of our monarch points on that. But that hasn't happened yet. So that will hopefully also give us a large city, 30 development. And we'll be able to embrace the Renaissance, so that will help with this one. I don't think we're likely to accomplish any of the other things. Korea. Should Korea go colonial? What do we want to do first with our ideas as Korea? I mean, we're fighting hordes. And hordes actually have, at least in the early game, very good armies. So maybe we want to actually take a military idea group to increase our combat strength. I don't know. As Confucianist, we want humanist ideas. And I like to take either humanist or religious, which has been nerfed if you didn't know. Deus Vault is now at the end of the idea group. So I think we want to take humanist ideas as our first admin idea group. Because that will help us with our harmony. Because we have yearly harmony increase plus 0.25. We have another diplomat rig again. We could make friendly with Yeren. They're not friendly with Jun Zhao. So let's do... we don't want to send them an insult. Do that. Actually, let's send our guy back to Jun Zhao. Go and make some more spy network, please. And you guys don't need to be doing that anymore, so please... Oh, you've already returned. But hey, I've cancelled the mission by doing that. Let's go build a spy network there, and then I think we're going to go on to speed 4. We can actually build temples now, which we should take advantage of. The best we can get is plus 0.13. We'll go for that one. I like this macro builder a lot. Thank you, Paradox, for finally implementing this. Because it will save me a lot of trouble looking around trying to find the best places to build things. Also, did our force limit go up? It went up by 1. Okay. How is our unrest in these provinces? Okay, devastation in there is gone now. We do still have devastation here, though. That's going to take a while to tick down. I mean, what are our states like? Okay, so we have everything in our main country stated. But obviously, we don't have these stated. So we probably want to take the rest of this off Jun Zhao. That's belonging to Ming, so we're not going to be taking that. Looks like Jun Zhao's going to win their war against Yeren and get stronger. That's good, because that means we'll have more to conquer. Did our naval force... No, it won't have done, because we didn't take any naval territories, did we? Oh yeah, all our diplomats are actually doing something right now. Ming wants 4 dip points. Okay. I can understand, actually, as a player, having to periodically give another nation stuff like... mostly monarch points. I don't care too much about manpower and money. But having to periodically give another nation monarch points really sucks. I can understand why players will want to destroy Ming when playing in this part of the world quite quickly. We're actually gaining a lot of monarch points right now because of beating up Jan Zhao. Okay, we already have a claim. We have two claims on them, so we need 30 points, and then we'll get a claim on Ning Yuta. Quarantine the port. Unfortunately, we're not a great power. We're not too far off, though. If we eat all of Jan Zhao, we'll probably be a great power. Oh, we can't. Not that we can be, because we're a subject, aren't we? That's interesting. Does Ming's great power... No, Ming's great power ranking doesn't take into account their tributaries. Cool, those are done. Recall him from Ming. Making friendly with the Ashikaga. Ah, he will actually ally us. I'm going to do that. Let's have a look. Get one favour each year. Excellent, that's what I was hoping. So, because the Ashikaga Shogunate is actually only a two-province minor nation, we get a favour with them every year, despite the fact that they have a giant vassal swarm, who are mostly loyal to them. I didn't look at that properly, but at least what I did see from glancing over it, pretty much all of the daimyos are loyal. As it stands, so that's good. We're not going to stay either of those territories. We're going to wait until Haxi's attack Jan Zhao now. We may want to get rid of our alliance with them. Okay, recall. We can get one more claim on Jan Zhao, so we might as well do that. When does our truce with them run out? Where am I looking at? I'm looking over here. Truce of Korea until 61, so we've got another 10 years on that. Over those 10 years, what we probably want to do is force the Renaissance to spawn. Oh, what's this? Our queen has been adulterous. Tut, tut. We're going to get rid of her, I think. Oh no, that's going to upset Ming though. Okay, we're not going to get rid of her. I don't want to upset Ming. If Ming decides they don't want us as a tributary anymore, and actually they would rather have us as part of Greater Ming, or Central Ming. We are part of Greater Ming because we're their subject. If they'd rather we were part of the main part of Ming, that'd be bad for us, because there's no way we could take them. But that's going to be all for today. Thank you for watching. I've been James Rose. This has been EU4 Mandate of Heaven as Korea. The first of three episodes of a quick look at them. I hope you've enjoyed up till now. Please leave some comments below and a like if you feel like it, or a dislike if you don't, because they don't mean anything. But comments are appreciated. Tell me what would you like to see with Mandate of Heaven. I want to make a few special videos showing off various features in a bit of depth when the expansion comes out officially. So let me know what you'd like to see. And if you'd also like to see me play, also let me know what nations you'd like me to play when the expansion comes out properly for the main campaign. That's all I have to say, I think. So thank you for watching again. I hope to see you tomorrow. Check out the videos of the other nations I'm playing, and enjoy.